In this election season, the church, by and large, the African-American church, by and large, did not rebuke President Obama over the issue of marriage or anything else, and essentially abdicated its spiritual authority to be a voice. Being a voice and supporting someone is not necessarily the same thing. You can support somebody and still be a goad or a check to them. And if you don't think that's true, then you don't remember the conversations you had with your grandmother and your grandfather. Is anybody relating to what I'm talking about? There are always people in your life that loved you, that believed in you, but had enough clout and authority to push you and check you so that you would not do things that would keep you from destroying your own destiny. I simply will say not to turn this into a political discourse, because it is not a political discourse. It is a spiritual declaration. I'm simply bringing this out today that we are at a point where the compromise that is at the root of the American church is now manifest. And what we are about to see is the full-blown manifestation of end-time reality. In the end time, what has got to happen before Jesus comes is that there is going to have to be the full-blown manifestation of the true church. Somebody shout, the true church. True church. And the false church. Somebody shout, the false church. False church. And an attack on Israel. Shout, attack on Israel. Attack on Israel. And unless these three things happen, we're not in the end times. Can anybody say that you understand that to be what the Bible teaches on the main in the book of the Revelation and in the book of Matthew, chapter 24, chapter 25. Wave at me if you think that this has some biblical ring to it. If you're a Bible reader at all, you would say this has some kind of biblical sound to it. So we know before Jesus comes, there's going to have to be some kind of falling away, that this way toward God and holiness, that broad is going to be the way that leads to destruction, and narrow is going to be the way that really leads to life eternal. Come on, somebody. There are going to be a whole lot of folk who are going to say they're on the right path, but they're going to condone stuff. They're going to preach stuff. They're going to be advocates of stuff that's not going to be condoned by the Word of God, the will of God, or the Spirit of God. So we've got to understand that we're in this last day generation, and the way the clock is ticking, we're in the last of the last days. But that doesn't mean that Jesus is getting ready to come tomorrow. In fact, I don't think he's getting ready to come anywhere near tomorrow. I don't think. Because one of the things that's going to have to happen is that not only has there got to be a false church revealed, there has got to be a glorious church in manifestation. So I believe that we're going to have to see this glorious church raised up. But maybe what's going on right now is that we are finally waking up to the fact that there are a whole lot of folk who are calling themselves the church that don't have enough backbone to stand up and declare what they really believe and live out what they really believe.